Kinds here with Paddling Life. I wanted to ask you here at Tumwater Canyon at the put-in above the wall more about the Mangu hardcore paddle.
Well, what can I tell you? What do you want to know?
What's in the shaft that's covered with carbon? What's in the blade that's covered with carbon?
Alright, I guess you want a full rundown, right? Okay, well, I mean, I guess we could start with the design. You know, the bent shaft design has got a really long hand grip, so it allows a big range of paddler's box, and it's much narrower than, you know, some more conventional paddles that we're used to. So it's kind of, you know, suits people better. The shafts are made of, this particular shaft, the Mangu, it's solid cedar, not laminated. It's machined, and then it has a moderately heavy layer of fiberglass that it is a biaxial weave, biaxial meaning it's kind of like that, but it's a big diameter, so they are more or less straight. So it's almost like having a unidirectional carbon sleeve where the fibers are running more this way. And fiberglass has got a little more stretch than carbon, and it's tougher. So we put that on, and then we put a smaller diameter carbon sleeve, lighter carbon, and it's biaxial, and it's the angle of it is more like that. So although the carbon's stiffer, it's not running so in line with the shaft. So it's more on par as in the way that it stretches with the fiberglass. So it works together with the fiberglass. So it gives you a stiff shaft that has some flex and some great pop. A solid shaft as opposed to a hollow shaft is quite different, because when you make a hollow shaft, you have to put a very, very thick layers multiple layers of carbon and fiberglass, so that the shaft doesn't elongate and ovalize when it bends. So you're actually putting more carbon or fiberglass in the shaft than you need to for actual strength under tension, but you're putting it in there to give it stiffness to hold its form. Whereas when you've got a solid shaft like we have, a solid core, the cedar, we don't need as many outer layers. So that's kind of how it works. And one of the beauties of a cedar core shaft is that it's really warm. Cedar's a great insulator. So in the winter, put a pair of pogies on this shaft, your hands will be toasted, they'll be sweating.
And how about the blade? Can you put the blade for us?
So the blade, you know, if you look at the paddle like this, we've got, you know, some forward offset. It's not dramatic, it's probably about an inch and a half on the bent shaft, which kind of makes a nice balance draw. You know, when you're pulling on it, you can have a very loose grip. The blades are really well balanced. And the blades themselves have a carbon skin, as you can see. They have a Dynel edge, which most foam core paddles, actually I think all have. But this is one of the few non-full foam core blades that has a Dynel edge. So when we designed this paddle, we were trying to make a good all-round paddle that was durable and had a nice amount of power, but it's not, I mean, you can race with it, but it's not as powerful as some big race paddles. You can also play boat with it. It's a good all-round paddle that will suit virtually all paddles and paddling styles.
It's little smaller blade than say the Odachi, that means a higher cadence, more strokes per minute.
It doesn't mean that at all. The blades, as you can see, the shape of these blades, you know, they're very rounded. Now, the reason for that is to make a powerful blade that catches the water, you have to make it the actual this shape. As the more rounded it is, the more evenly the water that does spill off, it spills off, and you get less flutter. If you look on any slalom race, all the slalom paddles now look virtually like this. They're actually a little bit wider, but they're all rounded. Most paddle companies that are making powerful blades are going away from the radically sort of, you know, slanted with sharp corners.
Rectangular.
Yeah, because it creates flutter. The water spills off it erratically, and you can't make the blade catch the water so much. So although this blade is smaller, it's essentially a double concave. So it's not full dihedral. Dihedral is when the blade is like this and the water spills off it. You can make a blade that's got dihedral over the whole thing. You can make it nearly any shape you want. It can be ugly as you like, and the water will spill off it, and it will be relatively well balanced, but it won't be powerful, and you're essentially pulling the blade through the water. With a blade that has a strong catch, the blade catches in the water and you pull your boat past the blade. So yes, it's a smaller blade, but it's not that much less powerful. Most people say it's more powerful than a powerhouse.
So, like a Kiwi like yourself, it's small yet powerful.
Something like that, yes. And back to the construction. So, you know, as I said, we've got the Dynel Edge, which makes it, you know, durable, as you know. There's 6 layers of composite in this area here, fiberglass, carbon, and a Negra. So you don't have the thin sheathing that foam core blades have to keep the weight low. So the chance of puncturing the blade here is tiny. And if you do, it doesn't matter. It's just, there's no foam in there. It doesn't matter if it gets wet. You can drill a hole through it, it's fine. The spine is a composite foam fiberglass mix, which is tough. It's very dense, and it has on the back 3 layers of unidirectional carbon coming right up to here and all the way to the end, and 1 layer with some strengthening around this area where the blade meets the, you know, the neck, because this is like a, you know, a potential breakage point. So the thing about carbon that, you know, it doesn't stretch, but it breaks. So putting more layers of carbon doesn't make something stiffer, because the carbon doesn't stretch, but it makes it stronger because it's working together. So it's, you know, 1 layer versus 2 layers, it takes twice as much force to break it. So that's it. You know, these blades are really light. The shafts compared to a hollow shaft are slightly lighter, which makes basically the difference between holding the paddle and paddling with the paddle. It actually paddles lighter than it is because the blades are lighter, so your swing weight is less. And, you know, I've told people this, they kind of don't believe you, they use it, and they're like, oh, you're right. So, you know, it's not just me talking here.
What else? Being from New Zealand, and the experience you had growing up there, and being involved in an apprenticeship right out of sort of grade school into master fabricator program, is that what inspired you to make this, or were you just unhappy with what paddles you used?
I mean, really the way it started is, you know, my brother Andy's who's a boat builder and is a composite master, was, you know, been messing around for years trying to figure out a way to make paddles that were more durable, basically, and that wouldn't break. And I, as I got older, developed chronic tendonitis in both elbows. I tried a variety of bent shafts. They all, it made no difference. Andy gave me a prototype. Within a month, I had zero tendonitis, and I'd never come back since I've been using hardcore paddles, and that was like a big motivator to make them. Also, yeah, my engineering background and, you know, the fact that I got the ability to make all the machinery that makes these paddles, and that no one else had been making them the way we are, so it was all kind of...
Dreams. I've been having dreams, jumping on a trampoline,
flipping in the air. I never land, just float there. As I'm looking up,
suddenly the sky erupts,
sky erupts. Flames alight the trees, spread to falling leaves. Now they're right upon me. Wait, if I'm on fire, how am I so deep in love?
You're right, you can pull out a hole pretty well.
Yeah, we can have strong current working on it. That's when you realise that the blade, that what sort of power the blade is.
Unless
you
think,
if you know what it is, then
it's
real, then you really notice it quickly,
because
you know what's happening.
Huh. Let's party.
Crushing with a paradise. Paradise. Solid block of gold. Lying in the cold. I feel right at home. Wait, if I'm on fire.
Dream of